Bueno, amigos, tenemos una gran noticia para todos los coleccionistas, y eso es que la empresa que llevó a casa muchas figuras durante los años 70 va a regresar y se llama Mego, o Migo, como se conoce aquí, y está ni más ni menos que Paul Clark aquí conmigo, que es parte de la compañía actualmente, aunque durante mucho tiempo fue como muchos de ustedes, que nada más estaba ahí reparando las figuras. Y ahora que la compañía regresa por su dueño original, Marty la va a regresar. Bueno, él regresa con nosotros. Hi, Paul.
Hi, how are you? Hi.
Very well. So, please, first of all, Migo is coming back.
Yes.
What's the deal behind that? I mean, how come? How does this happen with this span of years of no Migo in the market?
When Migo went out of business in 1982, Marty was still in the toy business. He was still putting out the Power Glove for Nintendo. He did Sky Dancers. He did Magna Doodle. So he's been in the business all the time. I met him in 2004 and said, I want to bring Migo back. Okay? And he said, yeah, lots of guys want to do that. Show me you can get a real license, and then we'll talk. So I went out and got the Star Trek license and did faithful reproductions of the Andorian, the Romulan, Kirk, and Spock. And I brought it to his house, and he said, all right, you showed me enough full of it. What can I do for you? I said, I want to bring Migo back. And he goes, I don't know. It's not really. I want to do new things. I don't want to dwell on my past. So time went by, and recently he called me up, and Netflix did the Toys That Made Us series.
Made Us, yeah.
And he said, it's time. So I'm getting it. I'm getting the company back. You're in. Which is like the manager of the Mets saying, come on down to the ball field, put on a uniform, and hit some balls around.
So this is the case of a fan of the brand going to work in the big leagues.
Absolutely. I grew up, I live about 20 minutes from Marty on Long Island and New York. And I grew up playing with Migos. And then when I found out I wasn't the only grown man that wanted his old toys back, I started making replacement parts of them and having figures, bodies made. So to have the guy who owned the company, it's like Santa calling you and saying, would you fly my sleigh tonight? It is an awesome feeling.
So what about all these? I mean, you said you tried to do some reissues on Star Trek, but what about these newest versions? Like, you know, they're like super power things. They were the real Ghostbusters, all in the Migo style. In a few, it was recent on
Mattel?
Toy Stores. I don't know if it was Mattel. It was another.
Well, in 2010, I worked with Mattel to do a line of DC superheroes and real Ghostbusters.
Yes.
Called Retro Action.
Yeah.
And Marty, that was because Marty introduced me to Mattel.
Okay.
And he said, I'm not ready to do this, but this guy can help you.
Okay.
So that was with Marty's blessing. So I'm always beholden to him for doing that for me. He could have just said, see you later, you know. In the very recently, there's been other companies trying to do the Migo look and really not hitting it. And that was one of the reasons why he said, look, if other people are going to rip me off and make bad versions, I must come back and do the real thing.
Yeah, because I have the real Ghostbusters, and I have some of those Mattel and superpowers. Mm-hmm. And I said, this looks just like the Migos.
Right.
So that was
until you
really
play with them.
Yes.
In the package, they look okay. When you take them out, the poor quality shows.
Okay.
And that was one of the things that's really frustrating, is to see somebody make bad copies and try to put it out there for a lot more money too.
Yeah.
So instead of a reasonable price, what we're doing with Target, they're going to retail, the 8-inch are going to retail for $15.
Okay. So now we have Migo again.
Yes.
And we have licensing.
Yes.
So what do we have? We have the Fonzie from the Happy Days.
Right. We're doing Fonzie, Charlie's Angels,
Action Jackson,
which is the guy that started it all with Migo in 1971. Joe Namath, which they licensed in 1970 after he won the Super Bowl. Brady Bunch, Married with Children, Cheers, ones that Migo never did but should have been. Star Trek, Bela Lugosi's Dracula, and Charmed, and we're Facts Alive down there. And we're also doing two packs of, in the 8-inch, of I Dream of Jeannie and Star Trek Mirror Universe. And then on the 14-inch, we're starting with Batman, Harley Quinn, General Zod, and Wonder Woman. And there'll be more figures, two more waves coming out at Target. We can't tell you much about it yet, but they've got two more waves of product behind it.
So this is retailing now?
August 1st.
August 1st.
This will be August 1st in Targets for $19.99. A 14-inch articulated figure. We even used the original Mego General Zod sculpt. It was the Terrence stamp from Superman 2. That's why we went with Zod. Because, trust me, in Wave 2, we'll have Superman. So if you don't get Zod now, in a couple months, Superman will be on the shelves, and then you're going to wish you bought a Zod. But yeah. We wanted to start with like a B-list to kind of lead into the next wave, which is a better list. And then for holiday, there's a third wave of even better characters.
So now, and this is had all the trademarks of Mego, the clothes is or so it's real cloth. I mean,
yes, real cloth. You can remove them. Unlike a lot of toy manufacturers now that are just gluing the clothes onto the bodies. And all it is, it's better off left in the package. This is something you could actually play with. You know, give it to your children even. Imagine that.
I doubt that a kid knows who the Fonz is.
You'd be surprised. You know what? They're watching it in syndication. Like MeTV is a superstation that's out of New Jersey that is showing Happy Days and Charlie's Angels and Brady Bunch. So in selecting these, we looked for properties that are still being broadcast to new. Listen, when Darth Mio did Star Trek, it was in syndication. It was not first run. I knew about Star Trek from watching it in New York on Channel 11, WPIX, every afternoon. Okay. Same with the Batman TV show. That's really, you know, these shows have a long lifespan.
And now, I know the characters, the fantasy ones and stuff, but now we have Broadway Joe. I mean, we have a local superhero for the New York area.
As, you know, as native New Yorkers, Joe Namath always occupies a very special place in our heart as the man who won Super Bowl III in 1970.
The man who predicts he will.
Yeah. I was a little young at the time. I think I was 6 when they won the Super Bowl. So I was not around. But he's stayed an iconic figure. I'm amazed how many people still have a great attachment to him. So I'm really looking forward to, we're going to be doing other versions of Joe. This is an exclusive for San Diego Comic-Con, but then in later waves we'll be having more Joe Namath.
And today here at the con, we can buy?
Yes. Target let us have a small quantity to show here and sell to kind of get the word out.
So now that we have these licenses, can we dream on having things like, I don't know, things from the 80s, I don't know. These cartoons, Brave Star, Silverhawks, Master of the Universe, I don't know.
Really, the rule of thumb is show me the fan base.
All right.
Where, you know, you've got to, when you're doing, I mean, Mego is a great format, but it relies on what characters you're doing. So you have to identify the fan base, and that's how you can get a product that people will want, like, you know, Lord of the Rings. You know, that's an old property that actually has gotten new life with the movies and continues to bring in new fans. So that's one that you know, would be on the to-do list.
From the Rankin Bass
film. No, there wasn't, because Lord of the Rings was published in 1947. It was a book. And
I mean, in the 70s, there was a Rankin Bass film.
Right, it was a film. It came out in limited distribution. And at the time, Mego, I think, was out of business. Mego wasn't there. And there was a toy company that did Lord of the Rings. They'd, like small, or 3 3/4. But that's really the problem with that format, is you lose a lot of the detail that fans really like.
Now,
it's in the details,
right.
You know.
The devil is in the details.
Devil's in the details.
Now, Mego made this thing that now it's unthinkable because of licensing and all that corporative mumbo jumbo now. But Mego actually had produced things from Marvel and DC at the same time.
Yes.
So, thinking about that,
trying to share licensing. How about, let's dream on, Star Wars me?
It really is a question of the Master Toy License is Hasbro. We are making deals with Mass, you know, not specialty. You know, comic shops are specialty. There's been a rule with Marvel and Star Wars that started with Sideshow. When George Lucas saw custom-made Star Wars figures, you know, by Sideshow guys, he said, hey, why, said to Kenner, why aren't you doing this? And Kenner's like, there's no market for that kind of that kind of detail. So they said, look, if it's $80, if it's one character, you know, one figure, we'll let you make some, okay? And that's, when I worked with Diamond Select Toys on Marvel, that was the rule we had from Hasbro. $80 for one figure, you know, one. So, and that's not Mass, that's specialty. So when you're talking about wanting to put it in a Walmart or a Target, you need to have the Mass license. And then as long as Hasbro is the Master Toy License, they would have to give us permission. So even if Lucasfilm or Disney turned around and said, yeah, I want to see Migos, you still have to work through the existing licensor.
Well, that's just a thought. But yeah, the first and the most important thing is that Migo is back. Well, and it will be for a long time.
Yes, yeah. Marty is 75, and he does not seem like it. He looks like a guy in his 50s.
It's a part that we're really interested, because we're from Mexico. Yeah. We would like to know about international distribution. I mean, Target's not a store in Mexico City, right, but there's a lot of toys.
Right now, it's a Target exclusive. In 2019, it opens up so we can look into other arrangements. But unless Target really wants to keep it exclusive, you know, but it's a trade-off, you know. I know Mexico has been doing a lot of toy manufacturing and actually has tariffs on from bringing toys in.
Yeah.
So that kind of figures into it too. So the best thing at this point is online. You can go to Target.com and order these. You know, we get that from people in Canada and the UK, you know, like, oh, well, I don't have a Target near me. Well, the internet's open to everybody. So, and they will ship to Canada, Mexico, and the UK. Okay?
They do. Okay. Yep. So, well, we have big, great toys at a best price. So this is something really interesting.
That's the heart of Migo.
And we have Migo. It's back. And it's...
Migo's back, baby.
And, well, thank you very much.
Pleasure.
For being with us and give us this special look on the return of one of the giants of the toy industry.
Yes, thank you very much.
Bueno, pues yo soy Ricardo Méndez. Muchas gracias por acompañarnos en esta entrevista exclusiva aquí en Juegos, Juegos y Coleccionables desde la Comic-Con. Migo está de vuelta y se va a quedar un muy buen rato.